That is a llama. That is a mini horse. And I think these are goats.
Yes!
Howdy, y'all. You already know it's Baboon here for Puff Puff Bass. Baboon here for Puff Puff Bass. Baboon here, ladies and gentlemen. Headed back out to my Nana's old farm pond today. Did pretty well yesterday. Three bass, three largemouth. Biggest one was 2.5 pounds. Two catfish. One that was 9 pounds and one that was 6. Welcome to Willard, Ohio. And here's the pond. Not too big, but it holds fish. So as per usual, choice of bait today. The Sanko. It's the green and black speckle. I don't know if this is watermelon or what they call this. 4-aught offset worm hook. All right, here's the perch. Wow, he is ready to go. There he goes. All right, Baboon here. If you can't see, I'm sweating my you know what off. Been out here for about an hour now, and so far all I have is that one yellow perch. I've tried Sankos, tried a spinner bait. I tried a Rapala X-Rap, a little like swim bait. Either way, it's always a good time when you're out fishing, right? Cheers to that. All right, Puff Puff Bass. I am headed out to a new spot tonight. The other farm pond that I've been fishing a lot, I just feel like I've been overdoing it. I want to give it maybe a week or so to kind of, I don't know, calm down, I guess. I've been pressuring those fish pretty hard. Guy just got the beans out the field. They're about to be getting the corn soon. Yeehaw! Puff Puff Bass, stay tuned, baby. Baboon's gonna catch a big one. There they are, got the combine out.
Alright, here we are. This is the new location. Just talked to the homeowner. He said there's largemouth, crappie, and some bluegill. So I'm starting with a good old Sanko, the Gary Greentip, the go-to. First thing I'll throw out here, see what happens. So
well, ladies and gents, about the fourth cast with the Sanko. I got my first largemouth out of this new pond. Really dark in color. There's quite a bit of algae. So I think when they don't get as much sun, they darken up. That's what I've noticed at least, so.
And there he is. Not too bad. As you can see, there's quite a bit of algae right here along all these banks. That's why I think these bass get dark, because they're up in here and that sun doesn't get to them as much, but I'm excited about this pond.
All right, Puff Puff Bass Nation. Number two. Once again, not too big. This one's probably 3/4 of a pound. There's a lot more pond to explore. I think there's quite a few fish in here. I'm excited. There he goes. All right, I just released the third one. Took another cast, another fish. This is fun. These are all dinks. This one's 1/2 pound, probably 9 inches. But you know what? Doesn't always matter how big the fish is. I know that sounds crazy. We all like to catch big bass. We all like that 5 pounder, that 6 pounder, that personal best 10 pounder, who knows? But you just can't always get them. And you gotta catch a lot of these guys before you can get them. So number three, like I said, probably about 9 inches, about half a pound. So I'm gonna go ahead and get him back in the water here. All right, guys, I have to tell you, this right now is the most fun I've had fishing the entire year. Let go number three, took another cast, caught number four, and now this is what I'm looking for. That's a nice fish right there. Clamp him up. At, I don't know if you guys can see that, 1.64, so not quite two, about 1 3/4. But he's a chunky little bass there. I knew I had a pretty good one when I hooked up to him. He was, he jumped a couple times and he was actually putting up a fight. The first three didn't, but this guy did. So let's get him back in the water. That's a nice fish. I'll take these all day, every day. Baboon. Oh, he got me. I caught two over here. I caught two over here. And I haven't even gotten close to walking around the whole pond. Plus, there's another one. This is great. All right, I made a move to the other side of the pond. I was fishing right over behind me there, up kind of by the house. You could see my truck back there. I made a move over here on my second cast. I got another bass. I can't even keep track. I think this is number five. This pond is just absolutely stocked with bass. Having a bush, of course. I'm just using the go-to always, the Gary Green Tip. This thing is absolutely devouring them tonight. All right, so after that last video on my fifth fish, I clammed one more cast and I was gonna catch another one. I'm not gonna lie, it was two casts. I'm sorry, I'm not a liar. This one's probably 1 1/4 pounds like the last one. This is fun, a lot of fun. Number six, baby. Here he goes, number six. All right, ladies and gentlemen, my phone's gonna die because I'm using it so much. Number seven. Here he is, number seven, going back in the drink. Bet you can't guess what I just did. Caught number eight. Eight bass today. Baboon's on fire. Let's get number eight back in the water and go for nine. I almost just broke my leg. There's some holes here. But in the process, I got number nine, baby. That's him, double digits, number 10. Small guy, but we'll take him. Number 10, baby, number 10, number 10, number 10. Number 10, really small bass, 1/4 pounder. 1/4 pounder with cheese. I'll give you the cheese, buddy. You good? You good. That's a... check that shit out. That's a fucking llama. That is a llama. That is a mini horse. And I think these are goats. All right, we got 11. This is almost getting tiring to a certain extent, especially filming after each catch. If I didn't take the time to stop and film, I might have 15 by now or more. You're free. You're free. See you later. I will catch you again. So I only brought, well, I have both my rods with me. I have the Daiwa Tatula 7-foot medium fast action with the Daiwa Fuego 2500 with I think 8 or 10 pound fluorocarbon. I would really like to tie up a frog right now and try some topwater. I might if I have enough time, because I think that it would be pretty explosive out here on the top. All right, lucky number 12. There he goes. Oh man, I really need to go grab my other rod. All right, number 13. I'm gonna get 20 tonight. Mark my words, 20 bass. I might just quit at 20 and come back another day, because I'm hungry. This grass that I'm standing in is tearing my legs up. I am itchier than I've ever been, but it's worth it. So number 13 is going back in. Well, I almost just dropped my phone in the water. I just caught number 14, smallest one of the night. This is always the worst. I feel terrible. He got it in the eye. I mean, what are you gonna do? No one likes when that happens, but it's just a part of fishing. I've killed bass on accident because they swallow it too deep and you end up tearing them up trying to get the hook out. I've left hooks in bass thinking they stand a better chance if I just leave it there instead of trying to tear it out. This guy got it in the eye. I think he'll live. I don't know if that eye is gonna work anymore. I feel terrible. It was a good day and now I'm kind of just like, damn it, really? All right, Baboon back with number 15. One away from my personal best at 16 bass. Let's get him back in here real quick. I'm really starting to lose light here. Gosh, they keep doing this.